and temporal reasoning and handling inconsistencies. Before I give you the word, Dragan, I just want to encourage everyone to switch on their camera. That's just, we are in the pandemic, you know about it. It makes us see each other, interact with each other. Everyone says, oh, I'm missing the real life interaction. And then they switch off their camera. Switch it on and you see other people, you interact with them. It will be easier to ask questions, and it makes it just much nicer, specifically for the speaker. With this having said, Dragan, you have the word.
Thank you. Okay. Do you see my slides? Great, thank you. So the topic of this talk is how to revise intentions in a dynamic world. And first of all, I would like to apologize to the people that attended my interview talk in April 2019, because this talk will be in the same topic and it will be similar to that one. Before I start, I would like to say that this is a joint work with five colleagues, five co-authors, but basically the first three co-authors are working on me on the topic that I will present today. That is Mehdi Dastani from our department, and Marc van Zee from Google Brain in Amsterdam, and Leon van der Torre from Luxembourg University. So four of us started to work on this topic in 2015, and we published a series of conference papers on the topic. And then when we wanted to extend and summarize all those results in some bigger journal paper, we also invited our colleagues from USA, Thomas Icard from Stanford, and Eric Pacuit from Maryland University, because they had some attempts that is similar to ours, and we were partly inspired by their attempts, and we decided to join forces, and the result is the paper that is entitled Intention as Commitment Over Time, that is published this year. Okay, so I will start with a very brief historical overview. The first thing I would like to mention is the Timeful app, which is an intelligent calendar application designed by some people from Stanford and acquired by Google in 2015 for quite decent money. And the goal of the application is to store actions in to schedule actions, and maybe to restore the set of scheduled actions if needed. And one of the authors of that application, designers of that application, is Professor Yoav Shoem from Stanford. Why am I mentioning this? Because our work has same roots as this applicable work, namely in his short paper entitled "Why Knowledge Representation Matters." Shoem pointed out that there is a direct link between his previous philosophical and logical proposal on how to revise intentions and the ultimate success of his startup company. So I will come back then to those common roots and to that proposal from 2009. That Shoem's idea are known as a database perspective. Basically, Shoem sees intention revision problem as a database management problem. And he starts by clearly separating a planner from agent. So you can think about a planner as a human, and an agent can be an intelligent calendar. In this operation, the planner is responsible for high-level plans and transforming those plans to executable actions, and then he can store those actions. Actions that are stored in time are called intentions. So here we will have intention database, and the data intention database is a part of the agent. So apart from intentions, agents can also have some knowledge or beliefs that can come from a planner or can come from even different sources. And the part of the reasoning process that planner can delegate to the agent is how to internally hear reason with these two knowledge bases, and how to specifically restore consistency in some dynamic environment when knowledge and actions stored in time keeps coming. So there is obviously an interplay between what the planner believes and what she intends. So if a new belief comes that says that some action that is planned is not possible, then we can retract intention here. On the other hand, if we have new intention, then its consequences can be added to the beliefs, but they will only be of the form of weak beliefs, which means that as soon as we retract the intention, we need to retract that part of belief as well. On the other hand, we have strong beliefs about the world that are independent of planned actions. So this is the starting point of our work. We wanted to develop a solid formal framework, a logical framework in which we can represent this interplay and which we can use to study a revision of beliefs and intentions. So here is the contents. We have two very well established field of knowledge representation. One is a theory of knowledge revision or belief revision. The other one, so here we actually want to build on this, but those theories are, they are basically only developed for beliefs or some formulas that are basically mostly represented in a propositional logic. But on the other hand, we want also to revise actions. So what we need is a logic that speaks about action and time. And there are, of course, several logics already designed to speak about actions. But we are here specifically interested in finding non-empty intersection between those two fields, and our interest actually here lies here in the intersection. So first thing is to develop a logic. So here, not only speaking about logic about actions and time, but logic in general, we have this clear separation, syntax and semantics. So here we have formulas that we use to express knowledge, and those formulas have meaning assigned by models that belong to semantics. So if you want to reason about knowledge in a syntactical way, we need some inference systems for that, some set of rules or axioms. And if you want to show that our inference system that produces consequences of some set of formulas is good, then we actually want to show that it corresponds to the semantical notion of entailment. Basically, that is the goal of completeness theorem. So completeness theorem says that what is inferable in our inference system is what is a semantical consequence by models. On the other hand, we also have this syntactical part of belief revision field. We have the set of postulates, which describes how some revision operator should behave. What are the reasonable options? And the first one and probably the best known is so-called AGM set of postulates. And on the other hand, in semantics, we have models, and then we have the famous representation theorems, which says how to revise based on models if you want the postulates described by relating formulas to hold. So as we are here in the intersection, we are basically, we were interested in both. The field, our two main goals in this research were to define for which we can, on the logical side, we can define the inference system that is complete, and on the revision side, that we can design the set of postulates. Our aim is to extend AGM theory such that we can obtain extended representation theorem which relates models with those postulates. So how our formal logic looks like? We try to stay as simple as possible. So we are in a kind of propositional model framework. And we have a finite set of simple actions. So I already mentioned that these high level actions are part of the agent that we want to describe here. So we have actions here A1 simple action, and then actions have pre and post conditions. So what we can express are arbitrary propositions like P, but then we have time T assigned. So the time is here just index. T can be any positive integer. And the meaning here, that the proposition P is true in time T. Similarly, we can say that pre and post conditions of an action holds in time T. And we have a special operator do that captures execution of action A in time T. We already also have all the Boolean connectives. This set is complete, but we also have, for example, disjunction. And we have also this box operator that corresponds to a path switching operator of temporal logics. This box operator says that phi will be necessarily true in time, looking from a time t. Our semantics is the standard semantics, branching time semantics of CTL star. So we have trees, our semantics branches, and this branching corresponds to the multiple possible futures that depend on the actions of the agent. And then we have paths of those tree, and a model is a tree, and pi, which is an actual path of the tree. We have a true definition of the box T operator defined in a usual way. This formula means that looking from the time T in all possible paths, phi will be true. So here note that phi can speak about some faraway future. For example, 2 times t, right? So phi will have some other time indexes also in the as a part of a formula. Okay. Actually, we have trees, we have paths, but because paths are obtained by basically choosing actions which will be executed, we want our strong beliefs in this separation between strong beliefs and intentions. We want them to be path independent. We want to choose those formulas to represent beliefs that are that correspond to trees themselves, which basically means that they are closed under first those path switching operators and then possibly also Boolean connectives. So here is an example of what we can express in our logic. This is an example of a researcher that wants to travel to conferences, and he is now located in Utrecht, and he considers to attend 2 conferences. Here conferences are HK and AK, and they are in two times, right? So we can say time zero is the time of traveling to HK, and time one is time of traveling to HK. But then agent knows that he does not have enough budget for both conferences, but only for one. So he's that actually means that he believes that he can that it is possible to attend HK in time zero. He also believes it is possible to attend HK time one, but it's not possible to attend both. And then if he decides to go to HK, then he will not have money for HK. Then in the same time that HK happens, he can decide to do some other action like visiting a colleague at time one. So in trees, this is represented like this. This is not complete tree. The tree branches infinitely. But if we are in the state S0 and at the time zero, then in this time, we know we have precondition for going to HK, which means that we can go to HK, but we don't have to go to HK. In this time S0, we also know it's possible to go to HK, but it requires that we need to choose action of not doing anything before going to HK. On the other hand, here it's not possible to go both to HK and HK because there is no common path that contains both actions. Right, so here is how it looks formally in logic with satisfiability relation in this tree in some path. Here the path is actually not important because our formulas are closed under path switching operators. We can express something like in time zero, it is possible to go to HK and then not visiting a friend at time one, which is possible because we can simply choose here to go to HK, and then in this moment we can choose not to go to S4 but to S5, therefore not doing action visit. What is important from the previous example is actually even if it is possible to do HK, even if it is possible to do HK, it is not possible to execute both actions, and that's one thing that follows here in this model. So it is not possible in time zero to make traveling to HK in time zero and then going to HK in time one. So now I will just briefly introduce our two main results. The first one is a formal inference system. So we made a Hilbert-style system, a set of axioms and rules that are complete for our semantics. And that inference system is specific because it is designed to appropriately infer weak beliefs. And the idea behind is that the humans usually reason in a bit opportunistic way. If I plan to do an action, I don't need to be sure that preconditions hold now. I can just plan to do an action even if I'm aware that something can go wrong and that maybe it will not be possible to do it in the future. For example, if I now want to book some flight from Amsterdam to London in 1 month, it is possible that due to various reasons, the flight will be canceled. But I will still keep my intention to go to London, and I will only revise my intention if I learn that precondition explicitly do not hold. So in that reason, if I want to add intention to my intention base, I don't want to infer weak beliefs that precondition will hold. So if I plan to go to London, I don't want, I can keep my intention, but I don't want to start believing that there is no way that that flight will be canceled. So for that reason, we have this kind of asymmetry between pre and post condition. Of course, if I have precondition for an action, then I will have, this is a formal axiom, that it will be possible to do an action, but I don't want the other way around. Of course, preconditions are necessary, but I want my inference system to infer safe, weak beliefs. I don't want to infer this, let's say, wishful thinking. If I want to do some action, I want to start believing in its precondition. On the other hand, of course, if I want to do an action, after the action, is done, I know that postcondition must hold in the next moment. So we have, of course, a big set of axioms. Those are two that are relevant for the future story somehow. And we have completeness theorem, which says that our inference system will derive those consequences of sets of formulas that coincide with the entailment relation. Okay, so why is this now interesting? Because our notion of consistency is a bit changed here. Recall that our agent consists of strong beliefs and intentions, which means that when we have beliefs, we have some fact that are path independent. Those are the specific kind of formulas, not all formulas. And the set of intentions is actually a set of actions stored in time. So in our previous example, an agent can have intentions to go to each gate time zero and to visit a friend at time one. But then if you want to, in the revision process, to restore consistency of beliefs and intentions, we need to take care of the preconditions. So we need a bit of stronger notion of consistency than provided by this specific axiom. We formalize it by adding additional constraint that we call coherence condition, and we say that belief intention base is coherent if, in addition to consistency, it ensures that really the preconditions of intended actions are met. So this was quite technically challenging, but we have added that to the logic, and that was necessary step for proper belief intention revision. Our second result is the revision of beliefs and intentions. We proposed the set of 12 postulates for revising belief intention databases. We revise with a pair belief and intention, and the result is updated belief intention database. Of course, we can only we can put, let's say, empty action here and then revise only with the beliefs, or put here a tautology and then we revise only with action. But in general, we show that the revising with the pair is a little bit more powerful in some cases. Then we have some standard postulates that extend the AGM theory. For example, that the new piece of belief has priority when revising, that that the revised strong beliefs should not depend on the action A, but only on the beliefs, and so on and so on. Then we were interested in the representation theorem, and we obtained some representation theorem that in terms of pre-orders over models, and some selection functions for intentions. Basically, we proved that every revision operator that we consider satisfy those two, the 12 postulates that we proposed, if and only if it is defined semantically in a specific way with some pre-orders over models, such that the revised beliefs and intentions correspond to minimal models. Is very similar to AGM theory. So what were the difficulties in all this research? The first thing is that we use AGM strategies, and they work for knowledge that is finitely representable. So we cannot have possibly infinite sets of formulas after revision, and we are interested in iterated revision. As a consequence, we needed to restrict a little bit our belief intention revision operators that consider only revision up to some time t that is fixed in advance, which makes some sense if you think about scheduling and planning. And this that led to some more problems. So if we want just to revise up to some time t, then we need to take care that a revised belief intention database, because we work in terms of models, when we select those new models, that it's also bounded up to time t. So when we collect all the new models, we can represent them with formulas that have indices up to t. The second thing is even if we start with models that correspond to strong beliefs that are path independent, we need to ensure that the revised belief is also path independent. And then finally, we needed to process the revision with the pair in a fair way to give some kind of priority to beliefs and to take care of them before revising actions. Otherwise, we could lose unnecessarily some actions. Okay, so that's what we have obtained so far. At the end, I will just say that currently what we are working on and what in the future what we are interested in is how to extend our developed theory to multi-agent systems. So if we have many agents, how they can collaborate, can they have some collective intentions that can that they can perform together, and how to revise in that enriched framework. Okay, thank you. That was all I planned to say.
Okay, thank you for your talk. I guess we have time for a few questions. I see. Okay, there's something in the chat. Okay, do you, there's Florian Tamara asking a question. Please go ahead. Tamara, you raise your hand?
Yes.
Ah, very good. Maybe, Dragan, can you stop sharing?
Yes. Just a second. Right.
Yes, so I was wondering, at one moment you mentioned the requirement of coherence, so that the precondition should be met in order for an action to be fulfilled. But I was wondering, what kind of precondition should I think of? And is it possible that there are more than one precondition, or how could you say something about that?
Yes, so we left it a little bit general in the framework. So our preconditions are represented as one propositional letter. It is pre of A. But of course, in practice, they can correspond to something more complex, as you have said. So we can have two independent preconditions, then we would relate that propositional letter with the conjunction. Right? So we can say, I need to have money and I need to have flight available in order to go to Ichki, so then I can do conjunction. Sometimes we can use disjunction. If I want to pay something, I can either have cash or I have money on my credit card. So that is something that would be added on top. We want to be able to reason about preconditions and their influence and the revision, even if we don't strictly relate each action to some propositions P and Q, but that is very good remark in some of the related work of other researchers, they made that link explicit. But because we are just interested in the revision, then we left it open. But of course, in specific situations, we need to relate those pre and post conditions of actions with some other propositional letters. And that link can be a bit complex.
Okay, there's another question by Natasha.
Yes, I had a question about your temporal language. So you have the separator which says in the future on all paths everywhere. So you can also define that there is some point on one path where something holds. So this possible thing refers to one state and one path, right?
We don't have this linear time variance, mm-hmm. right? So we cannot say that something will happen in the future in a specific time.
Mm-hmm.
That is some simplification that actually mm-hmm. allows to obtain these results. So we have, uh-huh. if you think about CTL star, we have this path switching operator, but then instead of next and until operators, we only have time that is indexed. So we don't have options to say that something will hold sometimes in the future. It would require some infinite disjunction. We don't have expressive to speak about it.
And then you plan to work the same, use the same temporal language, but for sort of composite states of the system for many agents, or are you thinking of extending it to some kind of strategy operator?
Yes, actually we are thinking about it, and I think Mehdi also answered now. Yes, we are currently exactly working on that, and we are thinking is our language already rich enough to express these strategy operators.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, that is exactly the how to say what we retracted from CTL star is not to speak about until, basically. Because anyway, when we do revision, we cannot speak about infinite future. Then we don't have, we cannot represent beliefs with a single formula.
Oh, did someone spotlight something? No, okay. Okay, I think we are out of time. I think I want to pay more attention in the future to stay within the 30-minute time limit. A few people already left, so that because sometimes people have scheduled some meetings straight after. But so I would say let's thank Dragan again, and then see each other next week Thursday.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.